This is R.D. Sharma Solution, Class 11th, Chapter 29, Limits, MCQ we are taking. Now, fx equals x sin x is x not equal to 0, 0 when it's x equals 0. So, 0 is our critical point. Two values are given. So, what we are going to do here, we have to find out the limit extends to 0 fx. You know what we do here? We'll take left hand limit, right hand limit, and we'll try to find out whether the limit exists or not. So if this 0 is the critical point, some plus h, some minus h, this h is very small, h infinitesimally small, actually it is 0 almost. So we'll one time we'll place at 0 minus h, we'll call it as left hand limit. One time we'll call it as x tends to 0 plus, and we are going to put 0 plus h. So left hand limit and right hand limit, I'm telling you both. So x is tending to 0 minus. So we'll put in place of x 0 minus h. And sine 0 minus h. 1 by 0 minus h. And we have to change the limit also. Now this goes h tends to 0. Here also 0 plus h sine 1 by 0 plus h. And same limit again we'll change it to h tends to 0 from x tends to 0 minus and 0 plus. So it will be minus h sine minus 1 by h. Now sine minus theta equal to minus sine theta. So you have minus sine of minus theta equals minus sine theta. So it's negative of minus sine theta. Okay, negative. I just forgot to write negative. So minus minus becomes positive. It will be h sine h. Here also it's 0 plus h is h and sine 0 1 by 0 plus h is h. So I'll talk about sine by h later. But since limit is h tending to 0, so since h is 0, whatever you apply in sine, h is already 0. So limit h tends to 0, so h, both will be 0. 0 into anything is 0. So limit extends to 0, fx equals to 0, this is the final answer. But let me tell you about sine 1 by h also, because it is coming in both the LHL and RHL. You know sine theta, theta can be any value. It can be any value. It doesn't matter. But it will, the range of sine is minus 1 and 1. So that is, you know, 0 into, you are multiplying 0 with anything between minus 1 and 1. That is why you are going to get 0 only. Next is 25. Factorial n by factorial n plus 1 plus factorial n. So factorial n. And I am changing this n plus 1 factorial to n plus 1 factorial n. Okay. And this is factorial n you can take from numerator, denominator. So you have factorial n you can take common, you have n plus 1 inside, n plus 1 and here 1. So n plus 1 plus 1. I am taking factorial n common. So I have factorial n cancels, limit n tends to infinity 1 by n plus 2. And you know in n is infinity, you will add anything with the infinity, it is going to be infinity only. Infinity is very large number, anything you add with large number is 2, so 1 by infinity is 0. B is the correct answer. Now next is question number 26. 4 root 2 minus cos x plus sin x to the power 5 divided by 1 minus sin 2x. If you remember, limit extends to a. X raise n minus a raise n by x minus a is n raise n a raise n minus 1. So how are we going to write 4 root 2? And this is cos x plus sin x to the power 5. So x n minus a n by x minus a. This 4 root 2 can be written as 4 is 2 square, root 2 is 2 raise half. And add this, power adds 2 plus 1 by 2. So this is 2 to the 4 plus 1 by 2, that is 5 by 2 it will come. So 2 raise 5 by 2. And what about this? This is cos x plus sin x, already it's raised to 5. So in order to make it 5 by 2, you can square it first and then you can multiply it by half. So 2 into half is cancel. So 5 is already there, so 5 by 2 it will come. 2 into 5 by 2 is 5 only. So you can write like this. Now, so numerator we have made it. Now denominator you need this 2 raised 5 by 2 and cos x plus sin x whole square. Because you need x minus a. X raise n minus y minus x raise n minus a raise n we have already got. So x minus a we need. So we need this 2 raised 5 by 2. So this is 1 minus sin 2x it is being given. You can write it as 2 minus 1 plus sin 2x. If you open this, this will be 2 minus 1, 1 plus sin x, 1 plus sin 2x, 1 plus sin 2x. So 2 minus 1 minus sin 2x it will be. So 1 minus sin 2x. So you can always write 1 minus sin 2x, 1 minus sin 2x as 2 minus 1 plus sin 2x. Okay. This 1 minus sin 2x can be written as 2 minus 1 plus sin 2x. Now you ask question, why 2 minus? Because we need 2 to the power something, right? Okay, numerator we have 2 to the power something. So you need 2 here. Now we will do something with 1 plus sin 2x. 1 plus sin 2x is what? Let me tell you, you know, at first go, you will be tempted to do what? But we have not, we don't have to do that. I'll just say 1 plus sin 2x will be 2 sin x cos x. Okay. How can we get cos x plus sin x whole square? We have to I upon this 1. Because cos square x plus sin square equals 1. Right. This sin 2x can be written as 2 sin x cos x. And 1 in place of 1 we are writing cos square x plus sin square x. So cos square x plus sin square x plus 2 sin x cos x. Okay, in place of 1 is cos square plus x sin square x. In place of sin 2x, it's 2 sin x cos x. So it's ultimately 1 plus sin 2x only. So 1 plus sin 2x can be written as, in place of 1, just put cos x plus sin x, so cos square plus sin square x. In place of sin 2x, put 2 sin x cos x. So it will be sin x plus cos x whole square. So now the denominator becomes 2 minus cos x plus sin x whole square. Right? So you have this A. And this is x and this is a. This is x to the power n minus a to the power n. So we can just, make it simpler also. Just assume this cos x plus sin x whole square as t. So 2 to the power 5 by 2 minus t to the power 5 by 2 divided by 2 minus t. T is cos x plus sin x. T is cos x plus sin x whole square. So this is now a formula of x raised n minus a raised n by x minus a. Let me do this cos x plus sin x first because we need the value for t. So cos pi by 2 and sin pi by 2, pi by 4, pi cos pi by 4, sin pi by 4, they are 1 by root 2. 1 by root 2 by plus 1 by root 2 is 2 by root 2 whole square it. So you are going to get 2. So in place of t, we are going to replace 2. So this is the solution. First, let us write what we are getting. N raise n a raise n minus 1. N is what here? This total is t. So 5 by 2 comes in front, n, a is what, t, n minus 1, 5 by 2 minus 1. 5 by 2 minus 1 will be what? 5 minus 2 by 3, that is 3 by 2. So 5 by 2, t, as I said just, we applied the limit, it was 2, 2 raised 3 by 2. Now what is t root 2 raised 3 by 2? 5 by 2, 2 cube under root, 2 cube under root. So 1, 2 will come outside and 1, 2 will remain inside. 2, 3, 2 to the power 3, to the power half, it's 8, under root. So it's 4, 2, 4 into 2, 2 comes out, 2 root 2. So this is 2 root 2. So just write 2 root 2, 2, 2 gets cancelled, 5 root 2 will be the answer. So A option is the correct answer here. A option. Now this question, we are going to apply RF twice. See. We have under root 1 plus under root 2 plus x minus under root 3 by x minus 2. Now we have to apply the RF once. Then again, in order to get rid of under root 2, we'll apply it one more time. So this is a minus b, just multiply by a plus b. So it will be a square minus b square. This whole square, a square. So 1 plus under root 2 plus x will remain here. Under root 1 plus 2 plus x, and here root 3 whole square is 3. So what are you going to get? A square minus b square. Simply I am doing a square minus b square. So 1 plus under root 2 plus x whole square. Already under root is gone, so no whole square. Under root 3 whole square is 3. 1 plus root 2 plus x, 1 plus under root 2 plus x minus 3. So you get root 2 plus x minus 2. So root 2 plus x minus 2. Now we have to multiply again by RF, because since we already have a root in the numerator, so same thing, just take the plus sign and multiply numerator and denominator. So root 2 plus x plus 2, root 2 plus x plus 2, you have to multiply numerator and denominator. This is a plus b, a minus b. Again, a square minus b square we are going to apply. Under root 2 plus x is 2 plus x minus 2 square is 4. So you get x minus 2. This is x minus 2. Now if you remember, this x minus 2 was already there in the denominator. Okay, whatever is there, just apply x tends to 2. So put it 2 here, put 2 here. 1 plus under root 4, root 4 is 2. So 1 plus 2 is 3. Here under root 3, under root 3 is already there. So 2 under root 3 will come. And here also root 2 plus root 2 plus 2 is root 4. That is 2 come out, 2 plus 2 is 4. 1 by 2 root 3 into 4 will come. 4 to the 8, 1 by 8 root 3 is the answer, 27. Question number 28. Limit extends to infinity, a raise x sine b by a raise x. So sine b by a x. The denominator you have b by a raise x. Okay, a x was already there. I just took it in the denominator. Otherwise, you can just assume it to be, we have multiplied by b to the power a to the power x. Okay, there is no b. Last b is not there. Okay, remember, it is not there. I'll just cancel it out. And this limit extends to infinity, b by ax, we are assuming it to be y. So a raised to infinity is infinity, b by infinity is 0. So y tends to 0. When we take b by a raised x as y, limit changes now. So this is sine y by y. And as I said, ax was already there. So we don't have to worry about ax. I just told you that whatever you have in the denominator, you have to multiply in the numerator also. But it is not required because ax was already there. We just have to multiply with b. We have to multiply only with b, nothing else. So as I said, a raised x was already there. B was only b will be there. So b, as we apply limit, y tends to 0. B is a constant, doesn't matter. Sine y by y, limit y tends to 0 is 1. B into 1 is b. B is the answer. 29. Now, this is the answer will be 1 by 32. So how to do this? We need to know the formula first of 1 minus cos 2 theta, and we'll combine them and try to find out the sine h by h formula. So here we have 1 minus cos x square by 2. So we'll take 1 minus cos x square by 4 together. So 1 minus cos x square by 4. And from these two, that is the second term and fourth term, we are taking cos x square by 2 common. I hope you got the idea. See, this is 1 minus cos x square by 4 and minus. So I am taking cos x square by 2 common from here. Cos x square by 2 common from here. And you have 1 minus this cos x square by 4. So from all of these, 1 minus cos x square by 4 we are taking common. 1 minus cos x square by 4. 4. Inside you have 1 minus cos x square by 2. Okay. Now if you see here, 1 minus cos 2 theta is 2 sine square theta. Or you can say 1 minus cos theta is 2 sine square theta by 2. Whatever theta is there, you have to divide it by 2. When you write 2 sine square theta by 2. So it will be 2 sine square x square by 4 divided by 2. This will be x square by 8. It's not x square by 4. I am going to change it. It's x square by 8. Remember. Here, second term, 2 sine square x square by 2. So 2 to the 4. You have 2 sine square x square by 4. 8 by x raised 8 is already there. 8 by x raised 8 is already there. Okay. So you have 8 here. And you have x raised 8 in the denominator. So for this, you need what? It is x square already. And since it's sine square of x square. So you need x to the power 4 in the denominator. So this is sine square, x square by 8 whole square. It's not x square by 4. I'm just going to change it. It's x square by 8. Okay. As I said, it's x square by 8. Let me change it first. X square by 4 divided by 2. Because 1 minus cos theta is 2 sine square theta by 2. So x square by 8. So you need x square whole square, that is x to the power of 4 in the denominator. And this 8, as I said, you need 8 square. So 64 in the denominator unit. So as I am saying, x to the power 8 can be written as x raised 4 into x raised 4. So 1 x raised 4 you will take here, and 1 x raised 4 you will take with the other term. Okay, 2 was already there. Remember, 8 is also there. We will use it 8 later. So 2 sine square, x square by 4. So we have x square by, this is 16. You need 16. So you have to multiply this 16 here also, 64 here also. Okay, this sine x square by 8 by x to the power 4 by 64, limit you apply, this is going to be 1. Because sine theta by theta is 1. So 8 was already there, 2 is there, this 2 is there, the 64 is there, the 16 is there. Now just cancel it. 8 is a 64, 2 8 is a 16, and 2 4 is a 8, 1 by 32, 8 4 is a 32. So 1 by 32 is the answer, 29C is the correct answer. Question number 30 here. Now alpha is the repeated root of ax square plus bx plus c. That is, when you solve ax square plus bx plus c, normal quadratic equation we have alpha and beta as the root. Here alpha and alpha are the roots. So how do we write it? How do we write it? We always write it as a into x minus alpha into x minus alpha. This we already seen in the when we are dealing with this quadratic equations. This ax square plus bx plus c is 0, and alpha is the repeated root of this expression. So this alpha and alpha are the root, alpha and alpha, repeated roots are there. So we are going to write in the way we have already learnt in the previous discussions. This will be tan. A always we take, because A we take common, and then only we make the minus B by A or C by A. So A into x minus alpha, this x minus alpha, x minus alpha. If it would have been alpha beta, x minus alpha and x minus beta we would have written. Here we have alpha and alpha. So x minus alpha, x minus alpha. That is x minus alpha whole square. X minus alpha whole square. So A we have taken outside here along with this. Now you have x minus alpha whole square. So what do we need? We need an extra A, because x minus alpha whole square, x minus alpha whole square we got. In the numerator also, denominator also. So I'm just making it as square. You need A. So A in the denominator, A in the numerator. And this whole is theta, and this whole is, this is theta, this is also theta. Tan theta by theta is going to be 1. When we apply limit, tan limit theta tends to 0. And how theta tends to 0? Because x minus alpha, if I put as y, and x is tending to alpha, so y will be tending to 0. So same thing which we have done already. So x minus alpha, if I put y, and x is tending to alpha, so alpha is 0, so y tends to 0. So you have tan theta by theta, it's clear, no? Tan theta by theta is 1, and a is only remaining. So a is the answer. So this question we are going to do in the next discussion. Okay? Till then, thank you so much. Take care of yourself.